I, in behalf of our college institution, particularly our beloved TIC, Dr. Pijuskanthi Dandapat, and our very, very senior and very honored departmental head, Dr. Dulal Chandra Maiti, I, Dr. Sunirban Das, welcome all of the participants, delegates to this lecture series. And obviously, I thanks and I really feel honored that all of you have joined in this lecture series and cooperated with us for last 1 month. We have tried to arrange different lectures, subjects and topics, which includes in not only the chemistry, but also in physics, as well as in different materials. Science that also includes medicinal, for example, in life science as well. So different streams students have joined, so I thanks them for participating in this webinar series of lecture, and I hope they have got some knowledge from the different sources and different resource persons we have tried to arrange. Obviously, we had planned to arrange much more, but since now it's almost the time when the state government is going to decide whether February onwards the college will start or not in this main time, and also the COVID situation gives us a very critical situation, and also nowadays this vaccination is going on. So on keeping the mind of these processes, we have decided that maybe in future we will try to arrange much more, but at least at the present condition, this will be the last lecture series in this series, right? So today we are going to hear from a very pronounced and very renowned researcher, as well as he's a very good teacher of chemistry. He is presently as a professor post in department of or school of basic sciences at IIT Mandi, Dr. Chandi. He's received his PhD from IIT Kanpur, and then he moved to Germany for postdoctoral research, and then he joined in IIT Mandi around 2010, and onwards he is doing very numerous research in different field, and that also includes the nanosciences, right? So today I've requested to Dr. Professor Jayakanthi Nandi to deliver some his thoughts and some basics of nanosciences and technology, which are nowadays a very important field of research, not only in the chemistry and physics, but also it extended to various parts of our sciences, includes medicinal sciences, life sciences, different not only in the basic sciences, but also in the applied engineering sections as well. Starting from our daily-to-day life uses of different nanomaterials, for example, our face creams, like sunscreens and so on, in the different sections of our coating materials for the better tensile strengths, better mechanical strengths, we always trying to use much more nanomaterials. And when we are going down to the size of this material, as we are calling nano, but definitely to have a particular size, 10 to the minus 9 meters, always you have know about this one. So going down to this size, we have observed certain fundamental differences of property, particularly its electrical property, its optical property, its mechanical property, as really varies. And this variation is maybe predicted on the view of very high surface to volume ratio, and also its band gap, which matches with the very fundamental properties of certain cases, right? So with this very short description, because the materials or in the nanoscience or in the if you case of the technology, we are saying nanotechnology is a very vast area, and this it extended to different disciplines. And nowadays, almost one-third of the various research peoples involved in worldwide are engaged in this kind of field, right? So you can just expect how much importance does this field have. So with this very short description in the field, and I'll just give that, I'll say that today we are very fortunate and very honored on the behalf of our institution, Bajkal Learning Mahavidyalaya, I, Dr. Sunil Bandas, thanks and provides our gratitude, our humble sincerity to Professor Jayant Kanti Nandi. He's in the Basic Science School Department in IIT Mandi, and he have very busy scheduled. So with these busy schedules, he have given us a small time such that we can also enrich the knowledge he have acquired through the last several years researching in this field. So no words I can say will be adequate to explain his expertise and obviously the time schedule he have given for us. So with this very minimum words, because I do not have really the words which can adequately provide the sincerity to him. So with this very few words, I request Professor Jayant Kanti Nandi to enrich us with his thoughts and the knowledges he have acquired. So I request Dr. Jayant Kanti Nandi to take over the dais.
Can you hear me, Suni?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. So I think everybody on that case can hear me as well. Good afternoon to all of you, and special thanks to your professor and Dr. Sunirvan Das. So I'm really fortunate and I'm really happy that after a long, long time, I am meeting some of the youngsters, young students. I also can remember our own college lives. In fact, I would say that your teacher, our Professor Sunirvan, was my junior in the college as well. So we have a very nice communication in between us. So, and I now really have the feelings by seeing all of you, although not physically, but virtually, whatever it is. But I just can think about those days. Anyway, so thanks, and I really or sincerely thanks to Sunirvan for giving me this opportunity. It's really nice for me in front of you people, and I think that you might have a little bit of encouragement as well. So what I will say here, this is very, very basics. I think Sunirvan already have said discussed to you a lot of applications part, but here I will not be going to the details anymore, or not a single extra thing, but I will show you about the nano dimension, nanotechnology, and their important applications by showing some kind of images and figures, and some of the recent work has been done in the field. Okay, so if you have any problem at any time, you just stop me. We can discuss on that time itself. Otherwise, let me finish. I think I can finish in maybe 40 minutes, and then we can have a lot of question answers. We can discuss all these things. Okay, so let me share the slide first, and then I will start the presentation. Just a moment. I am sharing my screen. And now I think you can see the slide. Sunirvan, can you see the slide?
Yeah, it's visible. It's visible.
Okay, so I think it is visible to all of you as well. Okay, so let me start here. So again, let me talk a little bit, a minute about me. So I am Professor Jayant Kanti Nandi from Indian Institute of Technology, Mandi. And I am in basically physical chemist, but the research work what I am doing in completely interdisciplinary. So I am working on biology, I am working on physics, I am working on nanomaterials. So there is a combined field. And whenever you are doing some kind of state of art work, there is no kind of barrier. So for gaining knowledge, you can have either physical chemistry, organic, inorganic, or physics, content matters, physics, whatever. But while you are working on the research field, there is no barrier in between the departments. Okay, so we mainly working at the moment nanomaterials for various aspects, for the fundamental understanding how the nanomaterials behave, especially their photoluminescence properties. If you don't know, I can discuss later on a little bit after the end of the talk. And we are also working on how these nanomaterials could be used for healthcare and then for sensor and devices. We are also working on some kind of high-end microscopic imaging, which I will not discuss. Okay, so if you see the title, I have put it very simple and brief. It is nanoscience and nanotechnology. I think you people have... Okay, I think some background noise, please take care. Okay, so this is very, very fundamental. It is title I have given, nanoscience and nanotechnology. So you can understand that it is all about the nanomaterials. And I have quoted one very famous line, which is the father of nanotechnology, we can say. I have written that there is a plenty of room at the bottom. And it was given by Richard Feynman in 1959, almost 60 years back, whenever people even not thought about the nanotechnology, though we have applications of nanotechnology. So he wanted to mean that where there is nothing you can see from there, you have a lot of things which could be applied to our humankind. And that's what he wanted to mention. Okay, so as it is all about your nanoscience and nanotechnology, which is basically with the nanomaterial. So, and the material is itself is a nanodimension as we are talking about. So let us first understand and try to understand in your real physical world or how you can imagine a nanometer size object. That is one of the important. Then I will show you several nanomaterials, how they looks like, how they are being synthesized, and how they have revolutionized our human beings, especially the revolution in the nanotechnology and how it is being used in several fields. Okay, so let us try and understand. So you can imagine, if I come to the next slide, you can imagine wherever you are sitting. Let's say you are sitting in some places at your home, maybe, or in the college or somewhere else, you are sitting and you can think about your size. You are maybe 1 or 2 meters in size, right? And now you can think about that, how much size do you have with respect to your room? You can think about, you can imagine, just try to imagine that how I am as far as the room is concerned. And then what you can do, you can now further think the size of you from the distance, or maybe from your hometown, maybe your village or your town. Then you can think about that, how small you are, right? So still it is not enough. Now if you think about our Indian map, here I have given the Indian map, you can see, and you can consider or you can think about that the distance between our North Pole to South Pole, right? North Pole to South Pole, if I talk about in terms of meter, in kilometer, it is roughly around 3000 kilometer, right? So now if I'm also marking here in the slide, you can see that the distance between north and south is 10^6 meter. And you are only 1 or 2 meter. So you can think about that from north to south, the distance is 10^6 meter. It means that your size is 10^6 meter smaller than our length of the of India from north to south. So you can understand how small you were. And if you ask that, let's, you can visualize something which is just from 2 kilometer or 5 kilometer distance from you, then you cannot see that object because it will be looking very, very small, right? Let's give some more practical information. whenever you are writing some kind of letter, so what you write, you just give write a kind of thank you, and at the thank you, you some people give some kind of exclamatory sign, and there is a dot, and this dot is roughly is 1 millimeter. You can imagine how millimeter it is. So it is 1 millimeter. So if you see that from the distance from north to south is 10^6 times larger than a meter of or a human size. Similarly, a dot, simple full stop, let's say full stop, whatever you are giving, that is 10^6 time larger than a nanometer, because it is a millimeter size object. So I think you can understand that how a nanometer is. You can think just about a full stop. Even if you come to the next slide, here I have again given some kind of comparison, and you can see, so everybody, almost all of you people are playing cricket or football, and I think you can see the animation as well. So you can consider the size of the earth or the diameter of the earth, which is around 12,000 kilometer, or it is in terms of meter, if I say it is roughly 10^7 meter, which is 10^7 time larger than a cricket ball. So now it is much better for you to understand, roughly 10^7 times larger than a cricket ball. So now you can imagine that you are holding a cricket ball in your hand, and now you compare the your state, West Bengal, or first of all you can consider your local region, then you can consider your state, how it is, then country, and then you can consider the earth. So it is 10^7 times smaller. Now you compare the nanometer size object, which was one of the famous nanomaterials, which is called fullerene. It is made up of carbon, right? And this is even smaller than a cricket ball. In comparison, the cricket ball smaller than the earth. It is 10^9 times. So a cricket ball was 10^7 times smaller, and the nanometer size fullerene is 10^9 times, another 100 times smaller. So you can imagine how small a nanometer size object. But this nanometer size object has revolutionized everything. I'll show you how it is, only some kind of basic examples. And now I'll spend another 1-2 slides just for your understanding, and then I will show you a video where you can clearly understand the size. And now let us come to a little bit on our more realistic. So we have compared human being in our country, even now, let me know anybody. I will explain also some of the terms if it is required. Otherwise, I'm explaining very slowly. Now you come to the bottom of the slide. There again, I have given the comparison of a human body. A human body consists of several parts like hands, nails, bones, and all these things. And each of them consists of cell. And this is all you have learned in your 12th standard or even 10th standard. And cell size is micrometer size, which is 10^-6 times smaller than a meter. And then which is another 1,000 times smaller than a small cell. And that is the size of the nanometer. Now here in the top, I have given an image of a human, and now I'm performing the video. So you just have a look, it is a 33 seconds video. I will repeat it once again, but first you have a look on the video, and the box, white box, you can see this white box is giving you the high resolution of the image. It means right now you can see this is 1 meter, then it will be coming, let's say 1 centimeter, 1 millimeter, and so on. And you can see that how a 1 nanometer in our body is simply sitting on. Okay, so I'm performing this video. You just have a look. slowly, slowly. Yes, so now you can have a look the video. You see the scale bar, the human tissue is coming, human here, then our tissue, then it is coming 100 micrometer size cellular, and then inside that you have 10 micrometer cell, then you have small 1 micrometer size further, and then finally you are coming 10 nanometer, and finally you are coming to a 1 nanometer size object. I think let me repeat it once again so that you have a little bit more understanding about this one. Just a moment. Yes, see once again how it is. So it is going further, further, then it is coming to your skin, going down to the tissue level, going down the cellular level, and then going down to the smaller parts, and then finally you are coming to your either protein or DNAs. I hope you can see the video. Sunirban, can you see the video clearly?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay, so I think this is what you can imagine about this video. Okay, now let's come to the presentation once again. So this is what you can imagine or what you can understand about a nanometer. Okay, and now let us show some of the further example where you can see the different type of nanometers at the bottom. I think this is, you don't need to remember at the moment, or I don't need to understand as well. So there are several type of nanometers, but you see the scale bar and their differentiation at the top. So right hand side you can see that I have kept one tennis, just a moment, I have kept one tennis ball. Once again, this is the same, you have this cricket tennis ball, what we people normally worked on, played on, and then you have a pencil tip, which is 1 millimeter once again. Then you can imagine that how smaller these sizes are. Okay, and these smaller sizes are basically the nanomaterials or nanoparticles. Okay, and if you see here the examples, there are several nanomaterials or nanoparticles. Those are also called as quantum dots. Several things in the nano regime you can think about. I will show you some of the important or very well studied nanomaterials which have been utilized in any of the research field or in our technology. That is, you can see that at the bottom we have several nanomaterials. One is polymer, I think you have learned a little bit. There is liposome, then we have metal oxide, so iron particle you can say. One of the most studies is gold nanoparticle. This has been used from the ancient time as well. So this is, and then we have the quantum dot, dendrimer, and fullerene again, it is carbon based material. Now what interesting of all these materials, why this material is so emerging and how it is revolutionized the humankind or our society. So let's discuss a little bit about this one, just in 3-4 slides, just to show you how and what are the importance. So let's come to the next slide. And if you see here, I have given one of the example, the most researched material, which is gold nanoparticle. And irrespective of any, either men, women, we all know how precious this gold material is, how price is going increasing day by day, right? And we all know how we can utilize these things in terms of ornaments. But whenever we have this kind of bigger size gold or bulk gold, normally we call it as, this is being, I have kept it in a hand, this is bulk gold, and this is, you can use just for ornaments. On that case, you do not have further utilization. But whenever you are making this gold mine into nanoparticle regime, or making it small pieces of the gold to the nanometer size, so what happened on that case, and if you can dissolve those in a solution, normally in water, let's say, so, and whenever they have the size, I am highlighting by red color. This is let's say 10 nanometer. And whenever this small size you have it, you have one color. You can see the color. And then if you are increasing the size in the nanometer regime, you can see that the color is changing. Okay, so this is, you can see by naked eye. It is only you can see naked eye. Means in direct visualization, you can see that the color is changing. It means what? It means that whenever this material is coming in the nano size particle, they are having some kind of inner property which gives this color. And this color is coming because of the light absorption. This is, I think, you might be reading later on, or if you know, then it is fine. It works on the Lambert-Beer's law, absorbance equals to ECL, right? So, and this absorption, there is a certain kind of instrument which is called UV visible spectrofluorometer, by which you can measure this absorption, and you can see that whenever you are changing, increasing the size, the UV spectra basically changes. We are not going to that one details. You just think about that this color. And now you can see here again in the bottom, I have kept one gold bar, which is very famous, and you people are very much fond of this one. You are very interested that if you have some kind of gold bar, let's say 200 gold bars for me, then my life is going to be heaven, right? But anyway, so now this gold nanoparticle, here it is spherical size, but you can also manipulate this size by making it as a spherical, or you can make it as rod shape, you can make it as a some kind of star, we can call it as a nano cluster, then we can make it as nano cage, we can even make it as nano star, or it is nano cell as well. Nano cell, it is a little bit complicated, I'm not going to that one, but you can see from here you can synthesize different kind of things, different size or different shape. And this different size and shape, whenever it is changing, it changes its color. Let me erase all these things once. Erase all. Yeah, so what you can do now, you just, what is changing, it is the color changing. Right, and the spectra changes. So this spectra means, if I say you in a raw or in a layman word, that it means it is absorbing the sunlight or the light for a certain wavelength. Now, depending on the shape changes, if you are having the gold nanorod, this spectra will change, be it is having a different region spectrum. And on that case, it can absorb another kind of light. So you can imagine that if I am absorbing this light, or if I am absorbing this light, so by using this light, it can produce heat. This rod or nanoparticle can produce heat. And this, whenever you are incorporating in our body, and if you have, let's say, tumor, cancer tumor, I will not be discussing this one, cancer tumor, then if you are imposing this nanorod to that particular tumor position, then if you shine the laser, it will be generating heating and it will destroy the tumor. So this is one of the major implications these days is being done by the gold nanoparticle. Okay, I'll come to this one once again in later on. Similar way, here is another, which is silver. The same thing for the silver also, you can synthesize or create silver nanoparticle. I am marking here the bottom, which is looks very nice. You can see how beautiful it is. But whenever you are looking on the bulk silver, this is not so looks good, and it doesn't do anything except making your cheap ornaments and all these things. But again, for silver nanoparticle, whenever you have in this nanometer size, and with increasing size, you can also see that the color is changing from yellow to fade, and so on. Okay, so these are two type of materials. And then one of the other fascinating materials, which is called as carbon, and you all people know about you not if you are not knowing, that is fine, but you are utilizing these things in everyday's life. Like you see here, this is graphite, then we have the charcoal people are using for fire and all these things, right? And whenever they are in the bulk condition, it looks so ugly, it looks so bad, and even you don't want to touch. Whenever you are wearing some kind of beautiful clothes for your functions, going for a ceremony and all these things, because it will dirt your hand, right? But whenever you are designing this bulk, either charcoal or the graphite, to the nano size, this looks like in the nanometer size very beautiful kind of colored material. So it is completely, this charcoal and these things are completely black, and it gives you only the fire and smoke. But whenever you are synthesizing in this region, it can give you this kind of gold, sorry, spherical nanoparticle. This could be also be created as nanotube. You can imagine your test tube. So in your practical lab, what you are doing, and just you make it smaller pieces, and that gives you the nanometer size tube. You can see here, those are made up of carbon. And the beautiful thing is that this nanometer size carbon, once again, with size variation, it is giving highly fluorescent color. And this color changes from blue to green to yellow to orange to red. So beautiful it is, which is not possible in case of this normal centimeter or meter size object. I have put it as centimeter. And these carbon nanomaterials, not only by using graphite or charcoal, you can use your, even I can show you, I can give you one example. Whenever you are boiling milk in your home, and if it is with a high flame, so if it is boiling more than its boiling temperature, what will happen? A black dust or black particle will be coating on your aluminum pot in which you are boiling the milk. And those black materials are nothing. Basically, those are carbon nanoparticles. You can give your, if you have the spectrofluorometer in your college, or you can give some of your seniors to test it, okay, please test whether it is having any light or not, you will get it. Okay, and not only that one, in your daily life, whatever you are using, like for example, here you have banana peels, and then you have cabbage, you have these cherries and all this thing, flour, all if you burn, even the fish scale, if you are burning, it will give you this kind of beautiful color, because all about us, we are made up of carbon. Majorly, we have more than 80% carbon in our body, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, right? So whenever you're burning those things, it is giving you the small size of this nano particle, which are beautiful in color. Now, one of the important and interesting properties of these, why these are so beautiful and interesting, is they are flexible. Now, you see in the bottom, I have put the charcoal or even the graphite here also, once again, for your understanding. So this charcoal and your graphite, you can now imagine, even the pencil, this is so hard, you cannot bend it. If you try to bend it, if you put a little bit pressure, what it will happen, it will break down. So that is the problem. One problem is it is not giving any kind of property, extra property. And if you want to bend it, it will be broken down. Now, this is beautiful, or this is beauty in this kind of nanomaterials. As these are made up of small carbon atoms or gold atoms or silver atoms or any other atoms, you can stitch them. Normally, whenever you are making some kind of flower kind of things, so what you do, you stitch. One by one flower you are stitching to make a thread, right? You are making sweaters and some kind of things, so you're stitching. So here what you are doing, again here using some kind of chemicals, that is, those are called as surface ligands, which are sitting on the top of these materials. You can stitch one by one of them, and you can give any type of shape. You can see here, even you can roll it down, and they are even harder or stronger in strength, hard carbon, I have written in here, then your charcoal or your pencil. And if you see that this video, what I have kept it for you here, that this, how it is being stretched, you can see in the right hand side, the caterpillar movement. So the caterpillar, because they are made up of small rings, so they can take any kind of shapes, right? And that is basically happen in case of your nanomaterial. Because of the surface functional groups, you can do it like this, and they are strength, highly stronger. So I think this is all about the fundamental basics regarding your nanometer size object or the nanometer nano dimensional materials. I have given example 3, 4. There are several kind of things. And now I will show you some of the examples and how this has been revolutionized our daily life. But in between, if you have any questions, you may please ask me, or otherwise I'll continue, and then at the end we can discuss. Okay. If you have any questions, Sunivan, if anybody has any question, or shall I continue?
If you have any questions, or at the end you want to discuss. Okay, you continue.
I think. Okay, fine. So now in the next slide, you can see the several categorized applications. I have so made it categorically. So you can use it. It's for information technology. You can use for the energy and light harvesting. You can use it for medicine. This has a vast application in medicine and healthcare. You can also use in consumer goods. Already Sunibha was telling to you that these nanoparticles has been used some kind of making your face cream and all these things, then water purification system, several things. But this has more or less important in your information technology and medicine. So I will show you some of the examples from the next few slides. This information technology and medicine mainly, or in the healthcare, right? So now if you come to our, how now I'll be showing you some kind of pictures or images, how it is being revolutionized. And some of you already have seen this kind of things, but may have not thought earlier, or some of you, some of the things might be new to you. Like, and these are very, very basics you are using for the daily life and daily day applications. So like, let's come to the next one. This is one of the simplest example how nanotechnology has been revolutionized to our and make ease to our life. I think, I don't know how many people you have seen this Sutter TV or the old age TV. So I have seen this TV in my school life. I can say till 10th standard or 12th standard, almost I would say 30 years ago, I have seen this Sutter TV. And you know that how much space it takes, and also not only space. So we had to do lot of modification, permutation, combination of the antennas. I think you know, you might have, some of you people already, or still you might have these antennas. So you need to make it a little bit adjustment. You can see that the man is trying to adjust this antenna. So then you will have the signal, and you will have a very few minimum channels, and all those channels are also being regulated by these regulators. And not only that, the most important part is the picture tube. This is quite interesting. So earlier, this picture tube may be kind of your 40 centimeter. You can imagine. So how much space? So if the picture tube is 40 or even more, I would say 40 centimeter. So that the total TV size will be around 60 centimeter, which is more than 2 feet, or 2 feet in width, and length will be maybe three, four feet this way. Right. Now, here is the nanotechnology comes, and you can see that there are these recent days, some of you people already have your LCD or LED TVs, which are liquid crystal display, call it as, or light emitting diode. Those are high ultra thin. And you can see here that this is my TV, and you can think about the thinness. So this is the thin, and it is maybe hardly 3-4 centimeter or even less. Right. And also, not only this one, you can see the pictures. And then recently, you have this curved TV also, 360 degree rotational curved TV. And not only this one, you also have all the things in a single television with all this high resolution. And this is, we are calling as multimedia smart TV. So the smart TV, you have everything sitting at your home. So this was the first revolution has been done. And then if I come to your what you people are using in daily lives, in your school, colleges, so you know the computer, how it is being revolutionized. Earlier in my PhD time, I could say, even Sunirvan's PhD time also, I can remember my PhD started at 2000. And on that time, I had this type of computer only, which is having this kind of CPU with a 1 GB memory only. And we had this floppy disk by that time, which is up to 2 MB. I have written already in the bottom. And you can imagine how size floppy was. It was roughly 4 cm by 4 cm. And the space is giving you only 2 MB. In these days, you people cannot imagine. I think all of you have the smartphone, or maybe some of the phones you have. You cannot think about a 2 MB space. In a simple audio music file, what you're listening these days is more than 4 MB or 5 MB. And these we have used in our PhD time, 2000, right? And the CPU, then it is being increased by 40 by 40 cm, which consists of all these things. But slowly, we have come across with the all combined things in terms of a laptop. And also, there also you have the mouse and the keyboard, everything was separated. And that has been clubbed here. And it is being giving you very nice laptop. And then you have the even Surface, iPad, and all these things. Similarly, from 2 MB space, earlier, we were so happy that if in my PhD time and later PhD time, if I could have got one CD, I was very happy because I could keep 700 MB of my space. And it can keep you 700 MB. But problem was that if you are buying this CD, if you are storing something here, then you cannot rewrite or delete things from here. Once you are using the CD, it is gone. Then we have this CD rewritable. So here what you can do, you can copy, you can erase, you can again copy, you can again erase. But nowadays, if you see, I don't know how much you people know that we can use this pen drive. I think pen drive, all of you know, but the size of the pen drive, I don't know whether you people know or not. A single pen drive, which is much smaller than your floppy disk, is 256 GB. Can you imagine the revolution has been done by the nanotechnology? It is only by the use of nanotechnology. I'll show you how it is working. And also, you have the external hard disk. Earlier we have used, which is of around 24 to 25 centimeter. Now we have the, and these external hard disks earlier was 1 GB, as I wrote to you here, it is. And now even external hard disks, which you can carry, that have the 4 TB. 4 TB is 4000 GB, which is 4000 times than your earlier this CPU was handling, right? So this is one. And then this is another fascinating, which is important. I don't know how much you or maybe who are familiar with these things. So in my school time also, I normally used to have, I was very much fond of music. So I normally used to have this cassette player. And I also had the Walkman with this cassette, which is of 5 cm by 5 cm. And it stores only 4x4 music, sorry, MP3 music. Then we have the CD player, and nowadays what you have, USB digital player, which is the size 1/4 times of your cassette, but it contains again thousands of songs, not only 4 or 8, thousands of songs. Even we had this video player and the video cassette. This video cassette is 3 times or 4 times larger than your smartphone on a phone. But what we do now, we can watch the movie in the laptop of these days, and also Finally, we can see everything in our smartphone. So this is the revolution has been done by the nanotechnology. Even the telephone also, you can see earlier we had to have this, the first one was being used by this way, Graham Bell used this one, and then we have development, and now you can see this was walkie-talkie. It was first generation, then second generation mobile, what we used in our MSC life, and then we have third generation, and now we have the fourth generation smartphone and all, and now we are talking about the fifth generation. And a single fourth generation smartphone, it contains everything. This is the mobile, and you can do everything, whatever you control from here. Right, these are the several things. Yes, and the future. Now you are, I think everybody, you have the either the normal 3G phone, third generation phone, or the fourth generation smartphone. But now the time has also started that you can wear this smartphone in your hand. And these are the two examples or the images I have shown you, that you can wear just like a wristband. We have the smart band also, but now the mobile, you can itself use it, and you can take the digital display on your hand. Even instead of carrying, you just wear in your hand, and then you can display in your hand. Right. So this is the thing, of this is the revolution has been done by the nanotechnology. And what are the importance, how it has been happened? This has been happened by, I will show you another two slides just for this one, how revolution. So you can see, you can think about that, this transformation of your SIM card. Earlier we used to use the normal SIM card, and now we are talking, then we have the micro, and then we have the nano SIM. And these days only nano SIMs are available. Right, you can see this one. These are all being transformed into a small size. Now in the next slide, you will get the glimpse how it is. Okay, so this is, I'm not discussing once again. This is what I want to say, that here in a simple single smartphone, earlier for each and individual, we have all these components to visualize or to understand. And now in a single smartphone with your several apps, you have all the informations by sitting at your room or your office or your college. Right, here is the revolution, how it has happened. This will be giving you the clear idea what about the nano regime has been done. So you can see the top, earlier all this nano fabrication or nano chips were in very, very large in size. You can think about that this man is working on this motherboard, I can say, for the computer, or let's say for the laptop. And you can see the size of this board in comparison to the hands. It is much, much bigger than our hand. Now, the generation changes from this one to micro to nano. So this chip or this electronic devices has been transformed to the smaller size. All the informations what you had here is being encoded or being kept in these micro devices. That is the beauty. Smaller, smaller, keeping all the information same, even better, not same, I would say even better. And this is micro level. And from here, if you compare, sorry, these chips are even how much smaller it is. It is the nano, and all the informations are being kept. So you can see here in the left hand side, again, I'm putting, so this, in this small chip, you can have all informations about you. I have given these images. It means that the circuit is being displayed in such a way that this small nano size with its circuit, whatever you can see here, either here or here, it's displaying the human face image. It means all our face informations are being kept in this nano size chip. And that is the beauty. And that is why, because as you have transformed this bigger size, let me erase once again, as you have transformed this chip to normal to micro, then to nano, and that is why you can think about all this revolution. I am coming back once again to these slides. That is why you can think about this revolution, especially I could say this memory, what you are seeing, from floppy disk to USB. Here I have drawn, or I may, once again I am showing, and then you can think about the again modifications from your cassette player to your simple digital player, which you can carry on in your simple in your pocket. And also you can think about this revolution from your cassette player, which is you need almost half of the room with its monitor, but now you can see in your mobile camera sitting at your home or even at night, you know, whenever, right? So this is the thing has been done or revolutionized by this fabrication, and this is basically nano electronic section. So this has a huge impact that how you can do modification. Okay, fine. And once again, I don't know how many people are aware of these things or not. Nowadays we have the quantum LED TV, and this quantum LED TV are what? It is made up of the quantum dots. Earlier I have talked about carbon nanomaterials or carbon nanodots. Similarly, we have semiconductor quantum dots. Again, they are showing this type of color. I am highlighting. They are showing this type of color just by changing the variation in size. Sorry, variation in size. It is from 2 nanometer to 4.2 nanometer. Only just you are changing 2 nanometer size, and you have the color from blue to red. So whenever you are combining all these quantum dots together, what will happen? It will generate or display this type of screen. You can see there are different type of colors has been generated. And from there, so earlier you had normal display, which are earlier we called as plasma or some others. But now using this one, quantum LEDs, you can have this kind of beautiful high resolution image. Each and every points of this TV screen, you can clearly identify, which was not possible in your shutter TV or your, but who are familiar still with those old TVs, still you need to modify your antenna's position so to get the better signal, right? Fine. Now this is again nanotechnology for several applications. We have this, we call it as wearable nanotechnology. You can wear these devices in your body to get a lot of information for medical, for other parts. Like here I have shown you some of the examples. Here if you see, I am not going to discuss, but let me tell you here, this is smart accessory security running watch, which is called it as smart band. We use smart glasses, who are fond of your Ben 10 and all these cartoons for the kids. You might be knowing Harry Potter, Ben 10 and all these things. They have the smart glasses. Then activity tracker, so how much you are walking, running, your heart pulse, everything will be monitored. So by this one, so here are several all these things I'm not discussing. I'll be discussing some of the important things here. So nanotechnology in healthcare devices. So we have all this type of devices you can create, and these are very, very small and tiny in size, so that you can wear in your any parts of your body, like smart textiles. So the clothes you can design, the material smart band here. Then you can design thermometers, nano thermometer. These are called as a nano thermometer. So this could be implemented inside your body and could be monitored from outside. So this is the thing what has been done by the nanotechnology. Okay, one of the most advanced and for which we are having this virtual seminar or presentation is one of the most challenging these days. And this is the example, one of the best example I can show you about the nanomaterials, that to detect your this coronavirus is one of the important, and still we are in very challenging phase. Still we have not recovered because of the problematic in understanding, in sensing those coronavirus, detection of the coronavirus and their medicine as well. So still we do not have these medications or the vaccines, right? So here nanotechnology again comes into play, at least how we can detect this coronavirus. So you can see that how people, you can collect the sample from the human being, then you can store it in the vial. Here are the viruses you can see, which is we cannot visualize. This is though in the picture we have shown, but as it is nanometer size, we cannot visualize. So virus basically looks like this one. And now you have a nanoparticle, especially gold nanoparticle solution, which is slightly violet in color, right? And whenever you are putting this coronavirus solution to this gold nanoparticle solution, as I told you, that it has the color changes depending on your size. So whenever you are putting this coronavirus to this test, to this tube, which is purple or violet in color, it reacts with this coronavirus and it is getting aggregated. These are bigger size particle because they are aggregating and they are becoming bigger size particle and the color is changing. So by naked eye visualization, I have put one of the eye picture also. For the naked eye visualization, you can see that there is a coronavirus. Even we have the kits also. So these kits are being fabricated by using this nanotechnology as well. Yes, this is the kit, how you use basically. So we have the very small size, which is maybe a pen drive size kit, where you can put your sample here and then sample will be moving. And then you have this three different color mark, which will be showing whether it is corona positive or negative, depending on the different color mark. And these are being made up of the small particles. So this is being, you can see that this is being the sample. Again, I'm putting here. This is the open part of your this kit. The kit is very small size, right? And whenever you are opening up, so what it is having? It is having this sample chamber. And then you have three different region where you are putting your nanoparticles. So depending on that, whether this nanoparticle will be interacting with this coronavirus. Earlier slide I have shown you that this one, the case that this coronavirus, whenever it is attaching with this gold, it is changing the color, right? So whenever you are making this as a device, what will happen that this, you are putting this gold nanoparticle here with some kind of linker molecule, you call it as, then whenever you are putting this coronavirus, it will interact with this gold and then it will travel in this way. And it will give you the signal. And that is where you can detect that whether I am having coronavirus positive or negative. This is one of the fascinating. Not only that one, how it is useful in our further medicine life, medicine or your healthcare devices. You can think about our space or satellites. So we don't know whether and how much or how far we aim to send the satellites from Earth to Moon or Mars. We want to see how is our weather and so on, but we cannot see them. They are far apart, thousand kilometers apart from us, but we control it from our human Earth by using some kind of technology. This is also one kind. So if you compare the same thing, that the nanomedicine or medicines are being implemented in our body that goes to the cell. And if you see that this is our satellite, which has been landed to your moon with its legs and all these things, then it is giving you the informations from the surface of the moon. Similarly, we can design in the left bottom, I'm showing you these nanorobots. These are called nanorobots, wherever you have kept your nanoparticle, nanomedicines and all these things, and it can directly go to your virus or infected region. And then it can deliver these drugs specifically to this region. Even you can see the right hand side, this is the nanorobots, which is hitting all these viruses and it can kill these viruses. And we control it from outside because we cannot visualize them directly, right? And then finally, we have the nanotechnology in the fuel production. Carbon dioxide could be converted. I think this is for the chemistry people is very interesting, that we can convert this carbon dioxide, which is not good for our health. Although we need to have the balance within our system, but whenever we have the excess carbon dioxide generated from the industry or some other places, so we need to reduce that level. And to reduce that level, people what we are doing, they are transforming it into fuels. You can transform it into the different kind, in propanol, ethanol. You people all familiar with these things, ethylene and so on. And these are being done by the surface of the nanomaterials, where you have, you can do the catalytic reaction. Okay, so these are one of the other applications, and we have several such kind of applications. So I'm not going to the details so much, but I think you have got some kind of glimpse about nanomaterials, nanoscience, nanotechnology, their applications. And now you can, maybe you can Google it a little bit more, as now you got some kind of idea, or you can email me anytime. You can contact me if you want to know more. We can discuss after this meeting if you have any more questions. But I think I'll stop here right now. But before that, I want to show my research group. This is my group tree, you can see. So at the top, all my PhD students, some of them are already graduated and got the degree. So this is some of the old pictures. So these are my four PhD students who has already completed their PhD in this field. These people are still working, and three more we have, which we have not, I have not kept it here. And these are the master students. So you are undergrad students, bachelors, and in our institute we have the master project in which these people do the master research work. And out of them, 4-5 students, after completing their masters, they are doing PhD in abroad, like Neeraj. He is in Israel right now. Gayatri is in Germany. Then Saksi is in Netherlands, and so on. And Akshita, she is also in Germany. And other people are also doing PhD and all these things. So this is all about my group. And finally, I would like to show our campus. I don't know how much you will be feeling. So it is one in a summer on the top left, top left. This is one sunny day in summer. We are covered by completely hills, but it is beautiful campus with all this hilly scenic beauty. And the other three are basically in a snow winter day. We had sometimes snowfalls, and whenever you have the snowfalls, it is becoming completely white, and you can see from the image and so on. So this is one of the beautiful campus, I could say. And we really thankful that we have this campus in this kind of scenic beauty place. We can spend a lot of time here. And finally, I could say that thanks a lot for listening to me for the last 1 hour. And now, if you have any questions, I'll be happy to take it.
Thank you, Chandra, very much for your ready request, receiving the request from us to give this delivery. Now, this session is open for the students, particularly. If you have any queries, any questions, any thoughts to share, so I will request all the students to raise the questions you have. If anybody have any questions.
Hello, sir. I am audible.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. When you are depends any relaxation life, okay, in our morning, by applying any biotechnology or nanotechnology, that's why. Let's say one example, landfall. They say, okay, landfall. In my modern era. Our modern era is a big problem. When environmental pollution, they can easily start diabetes, plant disaster, and goat plant disaster. How can this problem?
Your voice is disconnecting sometimes.
Okay, could you please repeat your question, because your connection was sometimes even disturbed.
Actually, that's of my internet problem. This will be that.
Okay. Just slowly. Go slowly.
Okay, okay, I will repeat this again.
Or Bangla-teo bolte paro. Bangla-teo bolte paro.
যদি বলি স্যার একটা কথা বলছি যে আমরা যখন মডার্ন এরা যত যত ডেভেলপ করছি, সেটা হচ্ছে বায়োটেকনোলজি হোক বা যেই হোক না কেন, মানে যত মানে উন্নতি করছি, তার থেকে কিছু কিছু বিশেষ করে টেকনোলজি থেকে ইলেকট্রনিক্স
তোমার কোশ্চেন আমি বুঝে গেছি, এবং কোশ্চেনটা খুবই ভ্যালিড কোশ্চেন। এবার তুমি যেটা বলছো আমিও তোমার সঙ্গে একমত, আমিও পছন্দ করি না এত বেশি টেকনোলজি। এন্ড দ্যাটস ওয়াই দেয়ার আর টু ফেমাস পিপল আর টেলিং দ্যাট ওয়্যার ন্যানোটেকনোলজি কামস দেয়ার ইজ এ এন্ড অফ দ্য লাইফ। ঠিক আছে, মানে একটা চেঞ্জ হবেই হবে, তোমার কথা একদম সত্যি। আমি যদি আমি কোশ্চেনটা তোমার বুঝতে পেরেছি, এত অ্যাডভান্স নিয়ে হবেটা কি, তাই তো? সেটাই তুমি বলতে চাইছো। একদম একদম সত্যি কথা, আমিও এই জিনিসটা তোমার সঙ্গে একমত যে যত আমরা টেকনোলজির দিকে এগোচ্ছি, তত কিন্তু আমরা ধ্বংসের দিকেও এগোচ্ছি। প্রচুর অ্যাডভান্স হয়েছে, ঠিক আছে, কিন্তু আস্তে আস্তে হচ্ছে, এবং কিছু ফেমাস লোক অলরেডি বলেছে there is a nanotechnology advancement, we are going to the end of the life. This is true. But আমি বলবো যে আমরা সব সময় চেষ্টা করতে হবে আমাদেরকে যে ভালো জিনিসটা ইউজ করা। যেমন আমি যদি আমার পার্সোনাল কথা বলি, আমি কিন্তু এই ফেসবুক বা টুইটার বা তোমাদের হোয়াটসঅ্যাপ এগুলো কিন্তু আমি একদম পছন্দ করি না, সোশ্যাল মিডিয়া যেটাকে বলা হয়। এটা আমার বলা উচিত না যদিও, কারোর বাট সবারই পার্সোনাল ওপিনিয়ন আছে। বাট যেটা দরকার, যেমন আমার আমার ক্ষেত্রে তুমি যদি ধরো, আমার ক্ষেত্রে একটা স্মার্টফোন যদি থাকে, আমরা যে ধরনের মানে প্রফেশনাল লাইফ লিড করি, বিইং এ প্রফেসর এট আইআইটি উই হ্যাভ টু বি লিটল বিট ফাস্টার দেন এনিবডি। সো আমার কাছে যদি একটা স্মার্টফোন থাকে, সেখানে যদি ফোনে আমার যদি ইমেলটা যদি আমি ইনস্টল করে রাখতে পারি, তাহলে কিন্তু আমি সময় সময় মেলটা চেক করতে পারি। মেলটা চেক করলে আমার কি হয়, যে টাইমে আমি ধরো বসে আছি সে টাইমে হয়তো আমি মেলের আনসারটা দিয়ে দিলাম যেটা ইম্পর্টেন্ট ছিল। আদারওয়াইজ আমার কি হবে, আমি ধরো আজকে অফিস থেকে বা ইনস্টিটিউট থেকে ঘর চলে গেলাম, আবার কাল সকালে আসলাম, তাতে দেখলাম কি অনেকগুলো আমার মেল জড়ো হয়ে আছে। আমি এসেছি একটা কাজের জন্য, কিন্তু তোমার সেই মেলগুলোও হয়তো ইম্পর্টেন্ট। তুমি ঘরে অন্য সময় বসে আছো, তখন কিন্তু তুমি সেগুলো করতে পারছো না, যেগুলো হয়তো মিনিমাল উত্তর দিলেই হয়ে যায়। আমি একটা জাস্ট সিম্পল এক্সাম্পল দিচ্ছি। অতএব আমাদেরকে বুঝতে হবে কোন জিনিসটা আমরা নেবো, কোন জিনিসটা নেবো না অ্যাডভান্স টেকনোলজি।
কিন্তু স্যার আমার একটা কোশ্চেন হলো, ধরুন আমি একটা সিম্পল ভাবে একটা জাস্ট সিম্পল একটু ভাবুন যে, ধরুন মেলটা ধরুন একটা সময় এসেছে যে আমি একটা কাজে এসেছি ইউনিভার্সিটিতে, দেখার জন্য আমার সঙ্গে 10টা মেল এসে গেছে, তো সেই সময় আমি ওই মেল 10টাকে ফরওয়ার্ড করতে খুব সময় লাগবে। এবার আমার কাছে যদি মোবাইলটা থাকতো, তাহলে আমি ইজিলি ওইটাকে ফরওয়ার্ড করতে পারতাম মানে সেম টাইম। কিন্তু দেখতে পাবো যে যখন আপনি ইজিলি ফরওয়ার্ড করে দিচ্ছেন যে টাইমটা মানে খুব স্বল্প সময়ের মধ্যে হয়তো মেলটা ট্রান্সফার করে দিলেন, ওকে নো প্রবলেম। কিন্তু আমি একটু জাস্ট সিম্পল ভাবো, কোনো একটা জিনিসটা টেকনোলজির সাহায্যে যদি আপনি তৈরি করতে থাকছেন, সেই জিনিসটা থেকে আমার কাছে মেন খারাপ ছিল মাথা থেকে, তো যত টেকনোলজি নির্ভর হয়ে যাচ্ছে, আপনি একটু কোয়ালিটি করুন। আগে থেকে যে স্টুডেন্ট গুলো বেরিয়ে গেছে,
সেটাই তো আমি বুঝে গেছি তোমার। হ্যাঁ তুমি বলো, কমপ্লিট করো তোমার কোশ্চেনটা।
মানে ওটাই বলে যাচ্ছি যে ধরুন আমাদের 1947 থেকে যে কিছু ডিসকভার হয়েছে, তার থেকে কি এখন তো আরো টেকনোলজি ফাস্ট, কিন্তু এখন কি থাকি আমরা কোনো ডিসকভার করতে পাচ্ছি, তারই সমস্ত কিছু মেনে আমরা খাচ্ছি।
এক্স্যাক্টলি, সেটাই তো হচ্ছে ইম্পর্টেন্ট। এবং এটার জন্য আমি ইভেন আমার স্টুডেন্টসদেরকেও বলি যে তোমরা এত কিছু না ইউজ করে, তোমার ফ্যাসিলিটি গুলো না ইউজ করে মাথাটাকে খাটাও। যখনই তোমার টেকনোলজি চলে আসছে, তুমি তখন তোমার ব্রেনটাকে খাটাচ্ছ না। যখনই ব্রেন খাটাচ্ছ না, এখন আমাদের এত সুবিধা হয়ে গেছে, আমরা তার পিছনে পিছনেই ছুটে বেড়াচ্ছি। হ্যাঁ, এবার ওটাই বলছি তো, এবার ওটাই বলছি, এবার ভালো দিকটা খারাপ দিকটা আমাদেরকে বুঝতে হবে যে আমরা করবোটা কি, চাইটা কি, আমার কতটা দরকার সেটা আমাকে বুঝতে হবে। সেটা কিন্তু খুবই গুরুত্বপূর্ণ এবং খুবই ইম্পর্টেন্ট। একদম তোমার কথা, একদম আমি মানে তোমার সঙ্গে আমি একমত যে এটাতে কিন্তু অনেক কিছু চিন্তা ভাবনা মানুষের অনেক কিছুই কমে যাচ্ছে, অনেক কিছুই আমরা আস্তে আস্তে হারিয়ে ফেলছি। আমাদের চিন্তা শক্তি, আমাদের ভাবনা শক্তি অনেকটাই কিন্তু কমে যাচ্ছে, কারণ আমরা ইনস্ট্রুমেন্টেশন মেড হয়ে গেছি বা এই টেকনোলজি মেড হয়ে গেছে, হাতের কাছে সমস্ত কিছু আছে। এই যেমন ধরো আমরা যখন কিছু পড়াশোনা করি, যখনই কিছু ভুলে যাই, সঙ্গে সঙ্গে গুগল করে নিই, জানি আমরা কি জানি যে আমার কাছে ঘরে স্মার্টফোন আছে, ইন্টারনেট আছে, গুগল করে না আমাদের মনে রাখার দরকার নেই, যার ফলে আমরা মনে রাখতেই ভুলে যাচ্ছি আস্তে আস্তে। একদম সত্যি কথা। কিন্তু আমরা যেটুকু জানতাম, যদি ভালো করে জানতাম, মেমোরিতে জানতাম, যে সেটা যদি আমাদের মাথার মেমোরিতে ঠিকঠাক করে থাকতো, আমরা কিন্তু কখনোই ভুলতাম না। এবং সেটা কিন্তু অ্যাকচুয়াল নলেজ, অ্যাকচুয়াল শিক্ষা। আমি একমত তোমার সঙ্গে একই ব্যাপারে।
আচ্ছা, আমার যে একটা সিম্পল কোয়েরিজ আছে, ঠিক কোয়েশ্চেন নয়, সেটা হচ্ছে আমরা যখন এই মেমোরি উই আর গোয়িং ডাউন টু দ্য সাইজ অ্যান্ড ইউটিলাইজিং দ্য মেটেরিয়ালস ফর বেটারমেন্ট অফ আর মেমোরি ইন টার্মস অফ সাইজ অ্যান্ড কোয়ান্টিটি, কিন্তু আমরা যখন সাইজটাকে লোয়ার করছি, মেমোরিটাকে হাই করছি, তাহলে কোন ফান্ডামেন্টাল পার্টটা মেমোরিটাকে মানে মেমোরির জন্য কাজে লাগে? মানে আগে যেমন আমাদের ম্যাগনেটিক স্ট্রিপ ছিল, তাহলে ওর ম্যাগনেটিক যে কোরিলেশন অর্থাৎ তার অ্যালাইনমেন্ট, তার উপর ডিপেন্ড করে তার মেমোরি স্টোরেজ হতো।
এখন
সাইজ প্রচন্ড কমাচ্ছি,
ঠিক এটা এটা বুঝে গেছি বুঝে গেছি। এটা পুরোটাই যাচ্ছে কিন্তু আমাদের সেই ফান্ডামেন্টাল কেমিস্ট্রিতে, ফান্ডামেন্টাল কেমিস্ট্রি যদি বলি, সেই যাচ্ছে কিন্তু আমাদের ইলেকট্রনস এর উপরে। যদিও সাইজটা ন্যানো মেটেরিয়ালের কথা বলছি, কিন্তু সেই ন্যানো মেটেরিয়ালসও আমাদের জাস্ট ইলেকট্রনটা রোল প্লে করছে। সেই ইলেকট্রনটা কত ফাস্ট কত স্লো, ইলেকট্রনটা কত কি ভাবে ও নিজেকে মডিফাই করছে ইন টার্মস অফ ডিফারেন্ট প্রপার্টিস, সেটার উপরে কিন্তু ডিপেন্ড করছে। সমস্ত কিছু স্টোর করা হচ্ছে কিন্তু সেটার মধ্যে, মানে অ্যাটমিক লেভেলে আমাদেরকে ভাবতে হবে, আমাদের কিন্তু অ্যাটম কে স্টোর করছে জিনিসটা।
তাহলে এটা গোয়িং টু দ্য অ্যাটমাইজেশন রাদার দেন উই আর সেইং দ্য ন্যানোমিটার।
না না না, ন্যানোমেটারিয়াল ব্লু, ন্যানোমেটারিয়াল ইফ ইউ আর টকিং অ্যাবাউট দ্য ন্যানোমেটারিয়াল অলসো, বিকজ ইফ ইউ টক অ্যাবাউট ইন টার্মস অফ দ্য মলিকিউল, উই টক অ্যাবাউট হোমোলুমো, হাইয়েস্ট অকুপাইড মলিকুলার অরবিটাল, লোয়েস্ট আন অকুপাইড মলিকুলার অরবিটাল, রাইট? আই থিঙ্ক ইউ অল পিপল মাইট হ্যাভ হার্ড হোমোলুমো অর S0, S1, দোজ আর কল সিঙ্গলেট স্টেটস। ইন টার্মস অফ মেটেরিয়াল, where we have talking about the semiconductor or other material, we talk it about in terms of the band, conduction band and valence band. This is all gaming play. This conduction band and valence band are nothing but the electron rich and electron deficient states. So whenever we have this electron, like you can think about gold, or you can think about simple sodium. I think crystal structure jodi tumra pore thako ami jani na, যদি সোডিয়ামের ক্রিস্টাল স্ট্রাকচার পড়ো, সেখানে সোডিয়ামের একটাই ক্রিস্টাল দরকার নেই, সোডিয়ামের একটাই অ্যাটমে সোডিয়ামের একটাই ইলেকট্রন আছে, আমরা 3s orbital জানি। তাহলে এরকম যদি থাউজেন্ডস অফ সোডিয়াম যদি তারা ক্রিস্টাল ফর্ম করে, তাহলে কি হবে? সোডিয়াম সোডিয়াম বন্ড হচ্ছে, প্রতিটারই একটা করে ইলেকট্রন থাকছে। তাহলে সেই ইলেকট্রন, একটা করে ইলেকট্রন যদি থাকে, আমার স্ক্রিনটা শেয়ার আছে নাই, থ্যাংক ইউ, দেখতে পাচ্ছো তোমরা সবাই? আমাদের কি হচ্ছে, প্রতিটা সোডিয়াম যখন, আমরা কি জানি 1s ইলেকট্রন সবসময় বেরিয়ে যেতে চায়, কিন্তু সেখানে যেহেতু সোডিয়াম মেটাল ফর্ম করেছে, সে বেরোতে পারবে না, সে একটা কি করে, উপর একটা ক্লাউড তৈরি করে, ঠিক আছে? দ্যাট ইজ ইলেকট্রন ক্লাউড, gives you a band, and there is another region which is called as valence band. On that case, amader kache prochur electron toiri hoye gelo, sei electron gulo ki hoy, amra energy dile, jemon ei solar energy je di, seigulo excite hoye chole jay hocche valence band e, ebong sekhane giye ora exciton toiri kore. Khub beshi deeper e chole jacchi ami, kintu etake bole exciton, jeta hocche electron ar hole pair er combination, and sei jinish ta role play korche, গেম প্লে করছে থ্রু আউট ইউর ন্যানো ইলেকট্রনিক্স, সোলার এনার্জি, এভরিথিং ইন টার্মস অফ দ্য ন্যানো মেটেরিয়ালস। সিমিলারলি মলিকুলার ক্ষেত্রেও তাই, অল আর প্লেয়িং বাই দ্য মলিকুলার অ্যান্ড ইলেকট্রনিক কনফিগারেশন মেইনলি, নট মেইনলি, দোজ আর দ্য থিং। অ্যান্ড দেন ইয়া, দেন ডিপেন্ডিং অন দ্য মেটেরিয়াল টু মেটেরিয়াল, দের আর সাম আদার মাইনর প্রপার্টিস প্লেয়িং দ্য রোল, বাট মেজর মডিফিকেশন উই ডু অফ দিস ইলেকট্রনিক লেভেলস অনলি।
Okay, in terms of its optical, electrical property as well as memory, okay, I little bit understand from the basis of band gaps and other thing. But if I come to the property like taste, let's say I have a cup of tea where I added pepper, dust pepper, very dusted, some crunched one or medium size. Maybe due to the size effect of these peppers, some extent of taste varies. Now if I try to correlate these things with the dimension, like the nano dimension, in terms of taste also, does it will also play some roles? Food grain size, whatever it affects maybe?
Definitely, but not always. It depends whether this nanomaterial is tend to interact with your food materials or not. Then only you will have the change, otherwise it is not. And moreover, these nanomaterials, as this I think Jayanta was talking about, he has a lot of nice questions. So these nanomaterials are not always good for our human health. We have to be careful on these things, that while we are dealing with these nanomaterials, we need to know how harm or bad for our body. So that is why normally whenever we do synthesize any kind of nanomaterials, we need to check the toxicity. This is called as toxicity, how much toxic it is. I think toxicity you people know. And that is why whenever you are working, or if you are doing these things, or if you want to mix this one in nanomaterials and then want to change, check before that, you need to think about what nanomaterials I am working on. And EPT is definitely, like as I told you, this carbon nanomaterials. Okay, so carbon dots or carbon nanotubes, as I told you, these carbon nanomaterials, without knowing or unknowing, you are eating every day. Whenever you are eating some kind of this roti, whenever you are making it at your home, it's being burned basically. It's being blackish color in some portion. Still we eat it. Tandoori roti, we still eat it. Then the milk, whenever you are boiling, it's getting burned and it is the blackish on the surface of the aluminium pot. And this still we eat, right? Then whenever you are making this makhan or ghee, then also we do or char the milk basically. That is also blackish color and we are eating every day. You don't know.
Okay, another student asks a question. Does the nanoparticle retain its elemental color?
Elemental color. Elemental color, if I say, this is not exactly the elemental color. This is a
bulk color, I guess.
This is not elemental color. Okay, I understood your point. So, like for simply, as gold bulk looks golden color, whether it is still keeping the same one not in your this one, that depends. But this is that depends because it is all about the playing of how it absorbing the light. The color comes from how it is absorbing and how it is reflecting. So depending on that, you have the elemental color.
So I can say may or may not.
Yes, it can vary. Like you can see that this carbon is black, right? Whenever you are seeing the charcoal and all this in carbon, it is black. But some carbon is completely colorless. Even you can think about the diamond, right? The two electrodes, the maximum two, the important two electrodes. One is graphite, which is in the pencil, and the other one is diamond. So they are in different color. Diamond is also made up of carbon, but it is not black. So these are all. Game of absorbing and reflecting the light by the material.
Okay, I hope all of you also have a lot of questions. So with the permission of Professor Shyanandi, I will take his email ID. If he permitted, I'll share to you if you have more questions regarding these topics, because this is really an interdisciplinary topic. So you'll have a lot of questions because everywhere you can see the nano and nanotechnology, right? So you have a lot of questions, a lot of queries as a part of graduate students. You have a lot of basic things you have understand, but obviously you have a lot of other questions. So I'll request him to, if he permitted, I'll give his email ID and I'll share with you such that you can, later case also.
Okay, Sunirvan, could see some of the questions in the chat box.
Okay.
Let me see and let me. So I think Subhabrata Bagh.
Okay.
He is writing. What is the basic difference between microtechnology and nanotechnology? This is a very interesting question, though. But you see, this is all about playing on the size. This microtechnology and nanotechnology is not much difference because fabrication more or less same. But is nanotechnology? You need more advanced technique to put your information in the nano level. So he wants the meditation or some pillar which has instant. That's these are research is going on in micro and nano also. Okay, then the next one is Ranjit Jana. Can you give me more information about the hand pump stone for the and also how it works?
Hello, please improve the sound system. Please improve the sound system. We are not getting fully.
I hope Sunirvan and others can hear properly. So I don't know.
Hello sir, we are not getting properly. Okay, Rahul, dekhun to
I think others can hear me properly. So might be, I don't know.
রাহুল বাবু কিছু প্রবলেম হচ্ছে কি?
You can please check your connection as well, Muhammad, because others can hear properly and they have put a lot of
No,
comments.
sir, we cannot hear properly. The sound system is bad.
I don't know,
Okay,
but
okay.
from my side, I think because Suniban and others can hear anyway. So there are, I think. There will be some kind of this kind of things and
In
so
virtual case, there will be a lot of problems,
yeah, there
obviously.
will be.
You
It
have
is
to have
not in my
contact.
hand because some people can say, some people cannot. So you may also check your internet connection
Oh, no, sir,
and
it's clear. It's not clear.
yes,
So
sir. Now it is okay,
continue.
sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine.
Please.
So then it's fine. So if it is okay, yeah, if it is okay, then it's fine. So I see another. Can you give me more information about the hand pump smartphone for the and also how it works? So this talk is not mainly of these informations majorly because these are technological development. And if you want to know more, you just try to search by yourself, right? Because I am not expert for those things. I just wanted to show how nanotechnology is emerging. Okay. And if you have further question, you can talk to me. Suniban will give you my phone number as well if you want. We definitely can talk.
Okay, I hope you have a lot of questions, obviously, but this platform is to just give a basic idea
Yes,
and
yes, yes, yes,
what
yes.
can we can where can we can
So
reach. Obviously,
yes.
there
So
is a negative and positive
how you
advantage
can
to it.
implement this one in your future, either academics or any other things? Just I gave a glimpse.
Thank
Okay.
you very much, sir, for giving such
Sure.
opportunity.
Okay. Now, with this one, I request to all the participants and also on the behalf of organization, I give a very hearty thanks to Professor Choyon Kantinondi for his giving time for his from his busy schedule to us. And I hope all of you have understand such some basics of this one. And there are a lot of scopes in case of application where you can go, and a lot of questions will obviously will occur, and a lot of debates, a lot of doubts will be there. If you get some what I can say, the inspiration from this talk, now you can utilize that one, right? So with that one, I thanks to Professor Choyon Kandinondi for his lecture. Thank you very much.
Okay, thanks.
Okay.
Thank you all.
I am audible.
Yes.
স্যার বলছি যে গুগলে আমরা যদি কোনো গেম খেলি, আমরা পাই যে ওটা অনেক সময় ভুল কিছু বললেও সুদা অনেকটা ঠিক হয়ে যায়। স্যার সেইভাবে কি আর্টিফিশিয়াল মাইন্ড তৈরি করা সম্ভব না এই ন্যানো বাট কাজে লাগিয়ে?
হতেই পারে, আর্টিফিশিয়াল ইন্টেলিজেন্স চলে এসেছে, জাস্ট গুগলে টাইপ করে দেখো, আর্টিফিশিয়াল ইন্টেলিজেন্স ক্যান ডু এভরিথিং। ইউ নেভার নো, তুমি জানো না কোথায় গিয়ে এটা থামবে। ঠিক আছে, ন্যানো রোবট তৈরি হয়ে গেছে, সমস্ত কিছু তৈরি হয়ে গেছে, এগুলো কোথাও তুমি বলতে পারবে না কোথায় গিয়ে থামবে। অতএব অত বেশি দূরে না ভেবে এটার ইউটিলাইজেশন কি হবে, কিভাবে আমি অ্যাপ্লাই করতে পারি, কিভাবে তোমরা অ্যাপ্লাই করতে পারো, আমি বলবো সেটার দিকে কনসেন্ট্রেট করো। বেশি আমি বলবো ডিটেলস, ফিলোসফিক্যাল কোশ্চেন, বেশি এর ব্যাড সাইড না ভাবনা চিন্তা করে গুড সাইডটা ভাবো সবসময়, যে আমরা কি ইউটিলাইজ করতে পারবো এটাকে কিভাবে। অবশ্যই তোমার সঙ্গে আমি একমত, আমি অলরেডি আগে বলেছি, কিন্তু অল ডিপেন্ডস অন আস হাউ উই আর ইউজিং ইট, হাউ উই আর ইউটিলাইজিং ইট, হোয়েদার আই উইল বি এ লেজি পার্সন অর আই ওয়ান্ট টু ইউটিলাইজ মাই ব্রেন, দ্যাটস অল ডিপেন্ডস অন আস অনলি।
ওকে চয়েন্দা,
ওকে, ফাইন।
থ্যাংক ইউ।
স্যার
আচ্ছা,
আরেকটা
সমস্ত
প্রশ্ন আছে।
আচ্ছা
সমস্ত
দাঁড়াও দাঁড়াও, শুভজিৎ আরেকটা কি কোশ্চেন করতে চাইছে?
আচ্ছা বলো।
বলছি প্রশ্নটা করা ঠিক হবে কি জানি না,
বলো বলো,
না না বলো।
ভুল ঠিকের ভাবার কোনো দরকার নেই, তোমরা এখন অনেক ছোট, বলে যাও।
যে স্কুল লেভেলে পড়ে
হুম
সে হয়তো কিছু একটা তৈরি করলো,
হ্যাঁ
তার মাথায় চিন্তা ভাবনা এলো,
হ্যাঁ
সে কিভাবে প্রকাশ করবি?
এই কোশ্চেনের আনসার দেওয়া তো আমার পক্ষে খুব মুশকিল। সে কিভাবে প্রকাশ করবে সেটা ডিপেন্ড করছে তার উপরে, প্রকাশ করার জন্য, হ্যাঁ নর্মালি এখন যেটা হয়েছে সব সোশ্যাল মিডিয়াতেই ছেড়ে দেয়, কিন্তু সেগুলো আমি কখনোই এনকারেজ করি না। যদি তোমার প্রকাশ করার থাকে স্কুল লেভেলে, সেটা তোমার যে সাবজেক্টের টিচার তাকে গিয়ে প্রথমে ইনফরমেশন দিতে হবে, তোমাকে ঠিকঠাক করে প্রেজেন্ট করতে হবে, তোমার স্কুলে ক্লাসে প্রেজেন্ট করতে হবে। স্কুলে ক্লাসে যদি সবাই অ্যাপ্রিসিয়েট করে সেটা, তখন তোমার একটু হায়ার লেভেলে যাবে, আরো তোমার বড় লেভেলে যাবে, এইভাবেই প্রকাশ হবে।
দেখো এরকম ধরনের অনেক ইভেন্ট আছে, স্কুল ওয়াইজ, ইন্টার স্কুল,
প্রচুর
ডিস্ট্রিক্ট,
আছে,
স্টেট, কান্ট্রি, ওয়ার্ল্ড ওয়াইড ইভেন্ট। হ্যাঁ, দের ইজ অলওয়েজ, দের ইজ লট অফ প্ল্যাটফর্ম ওয়ার দ্য ইয়ংস্টার্স ক্যান গেট এনকারেজমেন্ট বাই ডুইং সাম টেকনোলজি অ্যান্ড সাম কাইন্ডস অফ ফিলোসফিক্যাল আইডিয়াস। সো দের ইজ নট দ্যাট ইট ইস এ রেস্ট্রিকশন টু অনলি দ্য এল্ডার্স, বাট ইট ইস এ ওপেন প্ল্যাটফর্ম ওয়ার এভরি ওয়ান ক্যান জয়েন। So there is a lot of scope, lot of interest. Okay, so this debate will keep continue.
Yes.
So there
okay.
is no end. So I'll thanks to Chayanda for his giving this nice talk, because the time will just flow on. So with that one, thanks. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay. Bye.
Bye. আচ্ছা সমস্ত পার্টিসিপেন্টদেরকে আমি বলছি।